Before I start this video, I'd like to announce an announcement. In exactly 3 hours, I will be revealing my new plans for an entirely new channel. Watch for the notification. But in the meantime, the idea that a large body could be lurking in the solar system beyond the orbit of Neptune is not a new one. In an attempt to account for extinction events on Earth that seem to have a periodicity of 26 million years, in the 1980s it was hypothesized by some astronomers that there may be a nearly invisible brown dwarf or very dim red dwarf orbiting the Sun at about 1.5 light years in an elliptical orbit that periodically disrupts comets, sending them into the inner solar system to smack into Earth. This hypothetical star, known as Nemesis, has never been found, and more recent work suggests that while there did appear to be a strange periodicity inherent to mass extinctions on Earth, Nemesis's existence might not fit well as the cause. What the actual cause was remained an open question. But even more recent work suggests that the apparent periodicity in mass extinctions isn't actually there. Thus, there's no need to invoke Nemesis as a hypothesis. But ultimately, everything regarding this is still open for debate and subject to change as more work is done. Regardless of whether the Sun has a dim companion star, there is increasing circumstantial evidence that it may instead have a ninth planet lurking far beyond the orbit of Neptune. The contentious issue of whether Pluto should be considered a ninth planet set aside, I personally think it should be grandfathered in, especially given that we thought it would be an uninteresting ice ball and it turned out to be one of the weirdest and most interesting objects in the known solar system, so we'll call this one Planet X instead of Planet 9. Point is though, suspicions that a ghostly, unknown ninth planet lurks out there have been growing ever since it was first noticed in 2014 that there were similarities in the orbits of some outer solar system objects, including the dwarf planet Sedna. By 2016, more such objects had been identified that appear to be under the influence of an unseen planet. To explain the observed orbital anomalies of these objects, the planet would need to be about 10 times more massive than Earth, but little else can be inferred. Some of the possibilities that have been put forth to explain the presence of such a world are that it's the core of a primordial planet that was flung out by Jupiter early in the solar system's history. Also possible is that it was simply a planet that formed distantly from the Sun, and was disturbed into an irregular orbit by a passing star at some point long ago. Also on the table is that it's another ice giant, similar to Neptune or Uranus. But perhaps most intriguing is that the planet may not be native to the solar system at all, and may represent a planet that we captured at some point from another star system. Or it might also have been a passing rogue planet ejected from another star system long ago, only to be captured by our own, meaning that this would be a truly alien planet to our solar system from some other unknown place in the galaxy. This is not implausible, considering that we're now detecting interstellar objects passing through our solar system, such as the interstellar asteroid Oumuamua. But very recently, yet again, a new object was discovered that seems to provide yet another indicator that Planet X is lurking out there. In a paper by J.C. Becker and colleagues, link below, they detail an object known as 2015 BP519 that further bolsters the notion that a planet in the far outer solar system is shepherding objects with its gravitational effects. More, the discovery of this object confirms a prediction made by another paper by Constantine Batygin and Michael Brown, link also below, that more such objects with highly tilted orbits would be found. It's now to the point that there really isn't much else that could tilt orbits like that other than an unseen planet. This new planet won't be easy to find. Given its distance, it would receive and reflect very little sunlight, but astronomers are looking, and their equipment improves, so it seems that there's a very good chance that this planet could be spotted within the next few years. But I can't help to wonder one thing. Moons in our solar system are not rare, nor are moons with oceans underneath shells of ice like Europa. If Planet 9 has moons like that, and it turns out to not be native to our solar system, then one wonders what might lurk in those oceans. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular, in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.